How do you know the information a form respondent fills out is accurate? What's keeping them from giving you, say, a bad email address, which is quite possibly a contact's most important piece of information? When a contact enters an incorrect email address, this prevents you from connecting with them and prevents them from receiving valuable information from you. I'm Dustin Phelps with FormAssembly, and in this tutorial, I'll show you how you can add NeverBounce verification to your FormAssembly forms so that email addresses can be verified before submission. Let's get into it. So before we dive in, let's go over what you're going to need for this tutorial. As you can see, you'll need to use some custom code, which I'll include a link to in the description, and you're going to need your own NeverBounce account and a FormAssembly account on any plan. Now, if you're not already a FormAssembly user, don't worry, you can start a free trial of FormAssembly to follow along, and I'll include a link for that in the description. All right, enough of that, let me show you how this thing works. First, you'll need to grab a block of code that contains a unique API key from your NeverBounce account. To do this, go to the Apps tab in your account, then create a new app and select JavaScript widget. During setup, you'll need to add all the authorized domains where your form will live and add your preferred throttling and load balance configurations to finish. Now, copy the code with the API key from the new app you created. Next, we'll continue the setup in FormAssembly. Take the code you just copied from NeverBounce and navigate to the Properties tab of your FormAssembly form and paste it into the custom code box. Then save your work. After pasting and saving the code, you'll need to add two additional scripts to make the email verification work correctly. First, add the first bit of code that I've included above the NeverBounce code. This script essentially tells NeverBounce to recognize your email field as an email field. You'll replace TFA_XX with the field alias of your email field. To find the field alias, you can simply navigate to the Outline tab in the Form Builder and identify the field ID to the right of the field description. This script checks to see if the page is loaded, then assigns a variable name to the FormAssembly email field alias. The script then targets that field and adds data-nb, which is a snippet of code that NeverBounce needs to see to do its job. Now, go and grab the second code I've included and paste it after the NeverBounce script. Be sure to check to make sure that the order of these three chunks of code are in the right order, or else it won't work. This script checks to ensure that NeverBounce is ready and active. Once verified, the submit button on your form will disable until the form gets a result on the email verification. Based on the results of the verification, the submit button stays disabled and prevents respondents from submitting a form with an invalid email address, or becomes enabled if the respondent submits a valid email, allowing them to complete the form. Once you've completed the code customizations, save and test your form to ensure it works as expected before embedding it on your website or sharing it with your users. And there you have it, a form that will provide you with emails that never bounce. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. If you like this form building tip, please let us know by hitting that like button. And if you have any suggestions for future tutorials, please let us know down in the comments. If you want some more form building tips and tutorials, check out these videos here. I think you'll like them. Thanks for watching, and as always, happy form building.